Hi, I'm Daniel Smith, Southwest Regional Agronomist for the Nutrient Pest Management Program at the University of Wisconsin-Madison campus. Today, I'm going to be chatting with you about planning effective nutrient applications via writing a nutrient management plan and updating that plan under higher fertilizer prices. So there's a lot of benefits to having a nutrient management plan, and this is really evident under years where our margins are a little bit tighter, either due to lower crop prices or due to higher input prices like we're seeing in 2021 and 2022 growing seasons. So a nutrient management plan can help us take stock of our nutrients that we have on our farm. It helps estimate our soil and water erosion. It helps calculate our phosphorus index and calculates a field soil conditioning index. These are all really good metrics that we can use to judge how we're doing on our farm, if we're losing soil and phosphorus to the environment or not. And these all have costs. So if we can reduce these losses, we can help increase our margin, hopefully. So for example, typically when we write nutrient management plans, it's pretty common to see 1 to 3 tons of soil per acre lost in northern farms and 3 to 8 tons of soil loss per acre in southern Wisconsin by water erosion. If we put an economic value to this, it equates to about $20 a ton. Now think about trying to go out and buy a ton of soil. $20 is probably not going to get you a ton of soil delivered to your farm. So that's a pretty conservative number. So we see anywhere from $20 to $160 per acre lost just in soil. Now if we dive into a nutrient management plan, that can help us see how we can reduce soil erosion on our farm by reducing soil tillage, reducing possible years of crops grown to include more perennial crops, reduce soil disturbance by harvesting and that type of thing, these different crops. So nutrient management planning, we often hear, is expensive. So is there ways that we can write these plans ourselves? And absolutely, and it's free to do so. It just takes some time, and you do need to have your own computer that runs Windows to do SnapPlus. So contact your local county land conservation office for more information on this process. You are required to take a class on the basics of nutrient management planning. However, this is accomplished in several different ways. There's county and regional-based classes offered by University of Wisconsin-Madison Extension partners, as well as land conservation offices, and some technical colleges offer classes for this as well. You need to learn SnapPlus to write your own nutrient management plan. SnapPlus is a great piece of software. It's Wisconsin's nutrient management planning tool. It allows us to combine all of our nutrient sources, soil tests, and plan crop rotations to get some of these metrics and to calculate how much fertilizer we need to apply, purchase, and use via our manure sources. Our first year of writing our own plan, we do have to have a locally approved reviewer sign off on the plan, and then we want to review our plan annually and participate in update classes as they're offered. All of this information provided is for farmers. If you're a certified crop advisor, there's a little bit different process, and you have a little bit more freedom to write plans. If you take one of these classes locally as a farmer, you're only allowed to write plans for acres that you own or control via rental agreements, whereas a certified crop advisor could write plans commercially for profit. This entire process for most farms is free. You do have to pay for soil testing, which you should be doing anyways, and it takes typically about 8+ hours to start the process with the classes, and then 2 to 4 hours every year to update your plan. You will need to have a Windows operating base computer. However, you don't need to know how to run SnapPlus. We teach that, and there's plenty of resources to learn via videos online and opportunities locally. All right, nutrient management plans are not expensive. The assumption out there is that they are. However, they're really an investment in your farm. A 2012 study with 250 Wisconsin farms showed that 69% of farms save money with a nutrient management plan, with an average savings of $18 per acre. Soil testing typically costs anywhere from $2 to $7 per acre, so right away in the first year you paid for your soil testing expense. 65% of farms decrease nitrogen applications by an average of 54 pounds of nitrogen per acre. That equates to approximately $22 an acre. If you use some early fall prices, that could be as high as $26, $27 if you're buying nitrogen on those later fall prices in 2021. 51% of farms decrease phosphorus applications by an average of 32 pounds per acre. Now, everyone says, with these reductions, what does yield look like? And the study showed that 74% of farms cited no change in corn yield, and 18% of farms actually cited an increase in corn yield. by saving money on those nutrients, you're able to allocate nutrients to fields that actually need the nutrients or crops that actually need the nutrients. Like we often see in Wisconsin, alfalfa being short on potash applications. So how do I use SnapPlus to make good nutrient management decisions and fertilizer decisions? This is the cropping screen in SnapPlus. So this is diving into the software itself, and this is a great screen to look at all your data all at once. So this shows all your crops, all your fields for a current year, along with the soil test data. We move over to the far right-hand side of the screen. We have University of Wisconsin recommendations. This is over or under application numbers. So this is a recommendation, and then we have our over-under numbers on the right-hand side of the screen. So anything with a negative, we'd want to look at increasing. Anything that's over that number, we'd want to look at decreasing because we want that number to be right about zero. So for our first field here, our recommendations indicate that we need about 40 pounds of P2O5 or phosphorus and 105 pounds of K2O or potash. So we can think about allocating some manure to this field. Now, if we're thinking about just a blanket strategy of applying manure to every one of our fields, that's not necessarily as efficient as it could be because likely the fields closest to our barn, our farmyard, or easy access in the wintertime are already going to be high in particular phosphorus, if not potassium as well. So we need to be thinking about allocating based on crop need to reduce cost and reduce our need for commercial fertilizer while increasing our yields because we're going to be closer to optimum fertilizer levels. So what will happen if my plan's not up to date? This is a question that was sent in. You're going to lose money. And I say that because you're not going to be using the best data to make decisions. You're going to be making decisions based on soil tests that may be out of date, maybe by 4 years. You're going to have lost opportunities because you may be applying manure for 3 or 4 years to fields that needed it 4 years ago. However, they no longer need phosphorus as much as a couple of your other fields. And then you may have some tax challenges as well by loss of farmland preservation credits. You have to have a current nutrient management plan on file with the county in order to receive those important tax documents to turn in when you do your taxes. So diving into another question, what's the best way to address an overapplication of nitrogen identified in SnapPlus? That's identified as a red box on the cropping screen. Here for corn grain, we have 230 pounds applied as this year's fertilizer. It's red because we're 65 pounds over applied for nitrogen. So we dive into that a little bit more detail. And that recommendation comes from the MRTN. This is the system that Wisconsin uses to get our nitrogen rates, and that's a ratio. So for our particular field that we're looking at, this year, nitrogen is approximately 91 cents per pound if you're using a fall applied anhydrous ammonia product at approximately $1,500 a ton. Our corn price locally for sale next fall is $5.22 per bushel. That gives us a calculated ratio of 0.17. We're gonna round that 0.17 ratio up to 0.20. So that gives us a University of Wisconsin recommendation of 150 pounds of nitrogen per acre for our corn grain crop. Now to make those changes, we double click on that red box that was on that first screen and we can type in our urea rate. And as you see, this is 500 pounds. That's too heavy because we're showing it's 95 pounds over on this particular screen. We'd need to make an adjustment there. We just click on that 500 number and type in the appropriate number to get that number up here closer to zero. So another question that was sent in is, does my neighbor have a nutrient management plan? It's maybe. Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. If they're doing really well managing their farm, controlling soil erosion, controlling nutrient loss, more than likely acres owned by livestock farms are going to be under nutrient management planning. That's not to say that farms that are doing a great job don't have nutrient management plans. It's just that we more commonly see livestock farms over grain farms, especially in southern Wisconsin, have a nutrient management plan. It's required for any CAFO farms in Wisconsin, and it's required for certain cost share programs and local ordinances. Reach out to your local land conservation office if you want to learn more about nutrient management planning in your neighborhood. So is there an incentive for specialty crops? This is a pretty common question as well. And I say yes, there's a larger incentive for increased production and efficiency because those margins can be a lot more variable. So specialty and vegetable crop production greatly benefit from nutrient management plans. There's increased cost of production, and it's increased their incentives to have these. And then nutrient management plans help allocate expensive nutrients to the right acres, thus increasing the chance of positive economic returns from all your acres that you farm. To learn more about these topics, the SnapPlus website's a great resource to go to learn how to use SnapPlus, to learn about the resources available. And then there's this really nice publication put together by the Nutrient Pest Management Program on the benefits of a nutrient management plan. And that's where some of this data came from for this presentation. With that, please reach out to your local land conservation office for more information on nutrient management planning locally, as well as feel free to reach out via phone and email.